Welcome to Alchemy Wizard. I'm Tom. Today we're going to do a start to finish on Plasma Arc Rose Gold. Now I know many of you have ventured into creating colloidals with Plasma Arc. You've come to the same conclusion that I have when I started out with low voltage electrolysis stuff, that you'd like to have your colloidals as pure as possible. And unfortunately, with low voltage electrolysis, especially in the case of gold, when you're trying to create ruby red gold, you need to add quite a bit of chemicals. They're household chemicals, they're friendly, but you're still adding stuff to the mix. It's not a pure colloidal. And in the case of ruby red gold, you have to create gold chloride in the process before you can get the colloidals created. And gold chloride is, you know, in small amounts, it's fine in the body, but in larger amounts, it's not. Certainly in ruby red gold, it's not a problem because the gold chloride is so small, but you can't say that the solution is completely pure nanoparticles. The only way to get pure nanoparticles is with plasma arc. And some of the metals are very good at creating colloidals with plasma arc. And gold is one of them. And I'm going to show you how to get 20 nanometer, what I call rose-colored gold. It's in this family of ruby red. It's just a little bit of a brighter color, and that's because the gold chloride is what causes the dark color in the ruby red when we make it with low voltage electrolysis. When we're making it with plasma arc, you're going to see that we get a very light rose-colored material. But it is in the 20 nanometer range, which is what we need for it to be. But there's a trick to doing it with the plasma arc. Now I'm going to assume you guys have set up the transformer. I'll show you a picture of my transformer here. I have two transformers. Actually, I have a 15,000 volt transformer, and I have a right underneath here the desk. I have these two clip leads here are for my 10,000 volt transformer. I basically use the 15,000 volt transformer because it's more efficient. It gets a better arc. It's quicker, not by much, but it is quicker. But the 10,000 volt transformer works fine. It's just a smaller arc. It goes a little slower. Either transformer will work for plasma arc, and I have a video on the safety protocols of plasma arc and transformers. I'll put various links into the description section for those, so you can refer back to them on if you're interested in getting into plasma arc colloidals, which you should only do if you're familiar with working with high voltage 15,000 volts electricity. But let's get into the start to finish of creating plasma arc rose colored gold. Now, the first thing you're going to need is your wires. These are 24 gauge or 20, you can use 22 or 24 gauge or even thicker if you got it, gold wires. You'll need two of them. Unlike in the electrolysis process, you only need one. This, you're going to need two of them because you're going to be arcing, burning the metal off of each of these wires. So I have two here. And then, just for your convenience, I'm going to weigh these pieces of gold, and I'll show you a video right here of me weighing these golds, just so you can see how much material is going to go into creating our colloidals. Normally, I don't weigh them because I know it's somewhere the material. I know what the material use is going to be because it's the same over and over again. But let's just pretend we don't know so that you can kind of go along with us. So all right. So that's what we're going to do. We've weighed these rods. We now know what they weigh before, and we're going to weigh them afterwards. Now, with plasma arc, you can't have anything in the water at all. It has to be distilled water. And I'll even go on to say that distilled water that's fairly fresh, that you've made recently, within the last couple weeks. You could try store-bought distilled water. Sometimes I have trouble getting a really good arc with store-bought distilled water, basically because it's sat on the shelf for a long time and some of the plastic has leached, in very small amounts, has leached into the liquid. And it's kind of changed the properties of the distilled water so that it can't create as good a plasma arc, but it does work with store-bought distilled water. I'm just saying I prefer to use my own distilled water that I make here at 0 parts per million, of course. If you've got 1 or 2 parts per million, it's no good. You definitely need pure distilled water, so you've got really grudgy water. You're going to need to, may have to distill your water several times or pre-filter it like I do with the, I put RO water into my, which comes in about 8 parts per million, into my distiller because I have well water. And my well water isn't terrible. It's about 120 parts per million. Not like my sister's city water, which is over 300 parts per million. But anyway, I will RO the water first, put it in the distiller, and then I only have to put it through once, and I get 0 parts per million distilled water out of my distiller. Well, how you want to do it is up to you. If you don't have an RO set up or a filter, a zero filter set up to put it through first, then you may have to distill your water a couple times to get it down to 0 parts per million as measured on your TDS meter. And you'll need one of these if you don't have it. Absolutely have to have a TDS meter, at least for starting, so you know what your distilled water is sitting at. One other thing. The beaker must be absolutely clean. I wash my beakers off with RO water, 8 parts per million RO water, and especially after I'm cooking a really strong colloidal, I will clean the beaker with Dirty Labs dishwashing soap, which has no scent in it. No scent soap is important because the scent can be left behind on the inside of the beaker, and that will inhibit the plasma arc process as well. So you absolutely have to have perfectly clean beakers. You can't really rinse them in tap water. You're going to have to rinse them with distilled water or RO water to get the best, clearest plasma arc that you could possibly get out of it. One other thing, I use exclusive beakers, and especially with plasma arc, this is very important. This is a high volt. This says HVAC on here. It's basically my plasma arc beaker, and I do not put anything else in here. But this is used for the plasma arc process only. I have other beakers like this one here, which I'll use for low voltage electrolysis stuff, and they even go one step further, and that's with when I'm cooking the ruby red gold. I have a separate beaker for ruby red gold because sometimes if I like cooking silver or something else in this beaker and I don't, in low voltage electrolysis, and I don't clean this beaker out well enough, and I try to cook the ruby red gold, I will get some strange results from my ruby red gold. So when I'm doing low voltage electrolysis ruby red gold, I have a separate beaker just for that, just to make sure that my ruby red gold comes out okay. That's how picky these things can be. But the plasma arc absolutely, positively has to be perfectly clean. Use an exclusive beaker if you can. So back to the secret here. Now if I just take these rods, put them into my plasma arc top here, and I go through the process, I am going to get purple gold. Purple gold is about 40 nanometers, it's not 20 nanometers, and that's okay. It actually, you use less material creating purple gold than you do using the rose gold, but some people have done tests and claim that the rose gold is better than the purple gold. I stick with the rose. I tend to feel that the 20 nanometer rose gold is the way to go with plasma arc. So, but the trick is you have to preheat the water. We can't put anything in the water to change the size of the nanoparticles. What does work with gold, and only gold, it doesn't seem to work with silver or zinc or any of the other metals, is that if I preheat the water to boiling and I start my plasma arc process, I will create the 20 nanometer rose gold particle. So that's the first thing we're going to do. I'm going to take this beaker, put it in the microwave for 6 minutes, get this thing up to as close to boiling as I possibly can, and then we're going to start the plasma arc process. I'll be right back. Okay, there's my boiling water, or almost boiling water. And remember to use beaker tongs. You don't want to pick these things up. Or a towel with your hands, you will burn yourself. And of course, grip the beaker tongs nice and not too tight, but not too loose, because otherwise you'll break a beaker like I did in my little video. I'll put a link in the back where I was pouring stuff in here and it just fell out of the beaker tong. So you do have to be careful, otherwise you'll have a mess. All right, so water's boiling. Now let's put the rods in there and get going. This top is for, I use eyedroppers on this top. Just regular eyedroppers, and I drill little holes in here in order to, so that the water can come out so it doesn't back up out of the top. I have a video on this. I'll put links for this video as well on why I use the eyedroppers. But anyway, the eyedroppers are very good because they hold the wires very, very sturdy. To save filming time, I've put the wires in here and I've adjusted the gap on the bottom. I will take a picture of this gap for you so you see approximately what it's sitting at. Your gap's going to vary depending on whether you're using a 10,000 volt transformer or a 15,000 volt transformer and of the size of the arc. I like to keep my arc kind of small if I can, and the closer you put the gap, the smaller the arc will be. But now down here on the floor is my foot pedal switch, which I've always recommended. You have a dead man switch down here to energize this thing over here. I have a secondary switch back here. I don't know if you can see it. When I flip this, this is the primary switch, and then the dead man switch activates the stuff. I'm going to put my bullet in here. Got to put that in. I'm going to start the water spinning. It's very important that the water's spinning. And now I can't film the arc with this camera, but I'll film it with my mobile phone camera because the arc interferes with this particular camera. So let's start that process now. Welcome back. As you can see, here's our finished product. It's a light rosiest color. This is the ruby red, which is done with low voltage electrolysis. And you can see this is much darker, of course, but the colloidal content of this is much lower. This colloidal content is probably uses 7 milligrams of material and gives me maybe 10 parts per million colloidal content in here. This one here is a good equivalent to about, it's right here on this picture, and I'll show you over here. It's equivalent to 20 to 25 parts per million colloidal content and used 1 milligrams of material. Here's a picture of me weighing our little gold, rods. And you'll see that it comes in much, much more efficient over the colloidal low voltage electrolysis process. So what that means is more colloidals, less material, and it makes the colloidal plasma arc process more effective for you, in generally speaking. Well, that completes my start to finish on plasma arc gold. And if you made it to the end of this video, which is a little long, you earned yourself a cool. I'm Tom, Alchemy Wizard. I'll talk to you again soon.